Good afternoon, students. Welcome to history class. Today we will start a new chapter. This is chapter 9, Growth of Towns. You will find this in page number 63 of your book. Our lesson for today is section 9.1, that is factors leading to the growth of towns. Now, to understand the emergence of towns, first, we have to go a little back during this time when feudalism existed. If you can recall your reading of chapter 7, you will remember in the early Middle Ages, most people in Europe lived in scattered communities in the countryside, that is, in manors. So, in early Middle Ages, manorialism, that is, the idea of self-sufficient system, existed. If you can recall, each manor produced almost all necessaries of life. Both the lords and the peasants were hardly required to buy anything from outside. And in this economy, hardly anything was sold or bought. So, that was the scenario in the early Middle Ages when feudalism existed. But following Crusades, situation changed. How it changed? Trade began to flow again in medieval Europe, moving away from feudalism and manorialism. So, how did Crusade resulted into trade? Now, in addition to fighting during the Crusades, trade was an important component as new goods and ideas were exchanged during these times. Crusaders were actually this European people. They went to Jerusalem to capture that holy land. In doing so, what happened? They came into contact with empires that were in many ways more advanced than their own. They came in contact with Arabs. Now, these Arabs taught Europeans about advanced mathematics and the numeral systems. In addition to medical principles, they had long been forgotten. And when these crusaders went to fight these battles, they had to stay in that foreign land for a very long period of time, and over there they had to buy their own foods, and they were introduced to new items that they would bring back with them to Europe. So try to remember that the time when manorialism existed, people were confined to a manor. Whatever they needed, they produced over there. They didn't go outside to get new things. But during Crusades, what happened? People from these places, they started traveling. They were exposed to new markets. They were exposed to new things, be it food items or daily essential things. They were exposed to those things and they started using those things. And after the completion of battle, when these crusaders returned to Europe, they brought these things along with themselves and they distributed it in their communities. And these people who stayed back, they too started liking those things and they also started using those things. And this is how the need for these things developed in European markets. So, as I was saying, that crusaders had to buy their own food and were introduced to new items that they would bring back with them to Europe. These foods includes sherbet, sugar, coffee, fruits and rice. The introduction of new food items helped increase trade with the East. So, when crusaders brought those things in Europe, the common people started using those things and they took interest in these new things. And the demand for these things, which were new to them, increased. And this is how the trade increased with the east. So as demand increased, they had to bring all those things from the east. Besides food items, everyday household items were also brought from Muslim traders, which includes mirror, textile, carpets, selling compasses and all these things. It became obvious that the East was technically more advanced. When these goods were brought west, demand for trade was enhanced. Many of the goods were thought to be exotic in nature and the wealthy felt compelled to buy them. So this demand for Eastern goods which were produced in Eastern countries increased after the Crusades. Now how it led to the growth of towns? Now the increase in trade helped enlarge towns and cities in Europe because it gave the town and cities an economic base upon which it can grow. See, when there was very little trade in Europe, there was little reason to have towns, because think of that period of manorialism. People did not need anything to buy from others. They produced everything that they needed. So there was no need of a particular place where they can go and sell their things or buy things from others. There was no need as such. But when, as time went on, this new need generated. How? Because goods from Eastern countries started to come over here. And another thing we must remember over here is that there was a huge growth of population during that time, and the people, everyone was not peasant. Some of the population was peasant and others chose different occupations. They started producing different things and they started selling those things in the market, and that is how a requirement for place is needed, and the result was this towns. Almost all people lived on small farms, grew most of what they needed themselves and traded with other neighbors for what they could not make. This was the concept of manorialism. So there was not much of need for towns because there was no need to buy things from a central place. But after Crusades, when this new thing started coming in European land, trade grew, and that is when towns became more important, because it was the place where people could live and produce to gather goods to be traded. They became places where merchants could come and buy goods from town people and sell them goods from elsewhere in return. So the local people, whatever they produced, they used to meet in those places and they used to sell their produce to the merchants and to common people. And also the merchants, they used to bring this goods from other countries, mostly from east, and they used to sell it in the local market. This is how this concept of town emerged. And initially trade fairs or weekly fairs used to take place. People used to meet during a particular day in a week and they used to do the trading. That means they used to buy and sell their goods. But slowly what happened, as this trading increased or developed, these shops, permanent shops, started to emerge. And mostly was the result of Crusades. Europeans learned many new things from the Muslims, including different ways to build and sail ships and how to make and use magnetic compasses. Europeans were also introduced to many new trade goods while on Crusade, including silk, cotton, different spices and new forms of art and literature. The impact on Europe was tremendous. It increased the desire for trade with other parts of the world. This led to the rise of merchant class and the end of serfdom. From the time of Crusades, there was an intimate contact between the countries of the East and Europe, which led to the spread of trade and commerce in European countries. The commodities imported from the countries of the East flooded the European market, and the geographical location of Italy favored the growth of several prosperous trade centers over there. Italy, as you can see, was centrally located, which helped it make the center for the trade of goods and ideas. Following crusades, many important trade centers grew in Europe. Like Rome, an ancient city, developed into an important trade center. In Holland, Belgium, Germany, and England, large number of cities grew up, which were either seaports or trade centers. So you can see this yellow portion is the Muslim lands, and this purple portion is the Christian land. And you can see the routes of crusades are marked with different colors. Now you can see Jerusalem over here at the right down corner. So from here and from this eastern zone, that is from the Muslim lands, these crusaders used to take back the goods that they find attractive over here. Now the important ports, seaports and trade centers that grew were in Rome, Genoa, Venice, in these places. And all these places you see are the seaports. So it is well connected with the sea routes and it is near to the sea. And that is the reason why these areas grew as a trade centers during this time. Now, another interesting fact of this High Middle Ages, what we can say, is that all the towns had walls around them. Why? As you can see in this picture also, you can see this is a town and there is a wall which is guarding the town. And why this is required? Because to protect the town against armed robbers and enemy lords. So the merchants, whatever goods they used to bring to their town, they needed those things to be protected, and that's why they built this high walls around the town. So the merchants or the traders who first began to stay in these towns gradually settled down to become the local merchants, and the craftsmen left the villages and came to town to start small workshop. The growth of handicrafts and cottage industry was a salient feature of the medieval towns. So as I was saying you that after this feudalism, there was a huge growth of population, and while some of the population or some people used to be peasants and used to do agricultural work, other chose different occupations. Okay, they started handicraft, doing handicrafts and cottage industries, and whatever things they produced, they wanted to sell them, and that's why they came to the towns and settled over there. Initially, they used to come, say, weekly or monthly and bring their products with them and sell it in the market. But as the demand grew, they started settling in the town. You can see this concept in today's generation also. How? You can see that people, when many people who travel from villages to the cities, why? To get better prospects or better scope for their working. The similar thing happened back then also during the Middle Ages. People came out of that limited space of a manor and they started producing different things and sold those things in the market, and for that they needed a place, and that is the town. Initially they used to come for, say, a day, weekly or monthly, but later when they found that this trading business is of great demand, they started settling in the town, produced their things over there, and they started selling those. And what is the major effect of crusades in this concept of growth of towns? Crusaders, when they came from the east, when they returned after the war, they brought all these things from them, like the silk, cotton, different kind of food materials or daily essential goods, which were very new to this European people who stayed back in Europe. And they loved using those new things, and the demand of these things grew. And what happened? Few people, they did this travel regularly, and they used to bring back those things from eastern part, and they used to sell it in this European markets. And these those people who used to bring those things from the east were those merchants who developed this trade during this high Middle Ages. And another thing we must remember, that this areas like Italy, Genoa, Venice, these places are near to the sea, and these were the seaports where these merchants used to bring back their goods. And that is the reason why this places became trade centers during that time. So that was all for today. What you have to do now is open chapter 9 and read this section 9.1. And if you have any query understanding this portion, you will mail at the given mail ID. Thank you.